Well, before I talk about tonight's game, I should again condolences to all the members that have passed in the earthquake or been hurt. I thought it should go past them at this period in time. And our hearts go out to everybody on the east. You know, I have trouble pronouncing. But you know, I have children. My parents are gone. I just don't want to just pass that by because I know how that important is that to the country. And for us, we lost a basketball game last night. And credit to the team, we found a lot of character and courage to bounce back. That's nothing compared to what has happened the last few days. So look, condolences and hearts to those people, prayers to those people. In regard to today's basketball game, as I just mentioned, I think our backs are to the wall. Even though we've made the playoffs, we have high standards. We have a high focus to try and win this championship. So we have had challenges ourselves. Cooper injured, finished for the season. Jason injured, finished for the season. It's very difficult to just cover that and expect success straight away. So for me, this was the biggest test. Without me saying it, I knew this was our biggest test from a team perspective. With Shannon being here a few weeks now, and then you have a couple of losses, doubt sets in. So our focus was, I had a private talk with Shannon, a private talk with Coops, two key players, two leaders, about focusing on what we need to do as leaders to lead this team. And I thought these two guys really did a tremendous job today. We've been gathering momentum, we've been gathering improvement. Tang's here, he said he's going to be here to be interviewed. He's played three good games in a row now. See, one good game's not enough. He's played three in a row, he's contributing. It's not just offensively, it's defensively, and he's playing some point guard and controlling. It was great to see Kevin bounce back today. He rebounded well, he defended. Not bad yesterday, but today he played a great game. And so when we're at our best, Kevin's at his best. I think that's really important as well. Today, also, Tang did a good job. We were able to give Shannon some breaks, which has always been hard to give Jason breaks. And Tang did a great job running the point so we could play Kupsis and Aaron together, and they did a good job exploiting some mismatches. I still feel the biggest area for improvement today, we took care of the basketball, that was a big factor. I'm still looking for us to improve from a rebounding point of view, and I think that's the key to us probably going all the way. So I'm challenging the team on that, and I'm challenging our bigs in particular. I challenge Coops on that, you know. And he ended up with 9 boards in 36 minutes and a couple offensive rebounds. You know, Willie, I think, how many offensive rebounds did Willie get? So Willie's come in and got six rebounds in 12 minutes. You know, our four men, we're challenging them. So I'm just happy for the team. And now we're challenging for the top two. That's what we want to do. We got high standards, and that's what we're trying to do now. And which is we played some great basketball. To defeat a Mars team that's playing with a lot of confidence and getting some upsets. They've beaten some good teams, Mars.
在开始之前，教练还是希望这边先把我们这边的祈祷，还有希望真的是有受灾的，或者是其他目前还在救灾这些弟兄们，就还是希望不要因为这场球然后就忘记了，因为昨天有默哀，那今天的话，其实教练还是希望说我们台湾目前还没有脱离这个困境，那希望大家还是一样为他们继续祈祷。因为教练自己有孩子，然后他自己也是家长嘛，所以他希望大家还是持续的帮他们加油这样子。那昨天输的那一场球，今天的这场球，其实篮球都不比目前他们遇到的状况都还要来得重要，对，所以希望他们赶快度过。对，那其实今天这场比赛的话，我们真的是铁子打，因为我们真的已经需要把这一些球把它赢下来了。对，那教练其实给我们很高的 的标准。对，那尤其是子萱跟Jason 他们目前都已经没有在这没有办法打的话，其实这对我们来讲一直都是很大的一个挑战啊。那再加上Shannon 一开始来的时候，我们可能输了几场球，所以也外界也有可能会有不同的想法，所以我们也一直在去做一些调整。那目前Shannon 也慢慢的进入状况了，然后再来就是维杰今天。加上今天的话，今天去打好球打三场，所以教练对这一部分是很开心，因为你的防守，然后你在打一号部分的话，其实真的是有很大的帮助。然后再就是龙茂今天，比起昨天的话，今天状况也好很多了。对，那他今天的防守跟今天的篮板，对，那就是我们需要龙茂去做到的。对，那维杰其实。在场上打得好，其实我们可以让Shannon 多一点的休息时间嘛，然后也同时让 K 跟艾伦双打在场上，然后让他去做很多的错位，然后去做一些进攻的部分。但今天教练最开心的是我们的失误终于降下来了，但是希望我们可以更好，就是我们的篮板，因为教练一直希望我们的篮板要继续强，尤其是要季后赛。那 K 今天36分钟9个篮板。威霆今天12分钟6个篮板，其实这个几乎是2分钟一个篮板的话，其实教练是觉得很好的。对，那教练希望我们还是一样前两名排名，希望可以战绩还是以前两名做收。对，然后今天打战神其实也是一场很好的比赛，因为战神前面几场也把一些很好的球队被打下来，所以今天这是一场还不错比赛。
So compared to yesterday, just one night, you know, how do you switch, how do you change, you know, different type of, I mean, be more aggressive today, you know, what's the change, what makes it different?
I think we just wanted to start off with a better first quarter. I think we achieved that, winning that quarter 32-20. But after that, you have to sustain the lead. We went 3 out of 4 quarters, probably going to win the game. We did a great job just controlling the pace, controlling the game the whole time. Not only myself, but everybody's aggressive. I was talking to Tang a little bit about it earlier. When he shoots with confidence, a lot of times it's going to go in. Like he shot 45%, which is great for us. So, I mean, playing with confidence, shooting with confidence is going to be big for us always.
对，那其实今天宣能最主要的是希望我们第一节就延续我们昨天第四节的状况，所以他今天第一节的时候就把气势打起来。对，那他说其实从32-20的话，有没有办法去持续的压着他们？那就他宣能也说，四节里面如果三节打得好的话，其实就是有机会把这场球赢下来的。那最主要就是要怎么样把这个节奏掌控好，然后有自信的出手，因为今天进球率是45%，命中率是45%，所以他说大家只要有信心去投的话，其实我们就可以保持侵略性。
那维杰这边分享一下，因为教练其实在场上让你也说是打控球，也说是打3-4号的位置，自己在场上怎么样去调整，然后也让队友知道在干嘛，然后也让自己在进攻跟防守之间找到这样子交替角色的节奏。
其实最初赛季呢，教练是让我打控球的位置，那其实也磨了很久，然后现在有点能够放回到3-4号的位置，就是我比较熟悉的位置，因为毕竟篮球生涯都是打这个位置3-4号。然后，当打控球的时候，就是想办法看哪里有 mismatch 嘛。那中锋一直是我们的优势，所以就是要想办法把球喂进去，这样。对对对。
问一下维杰，今天其实展现蛮好的无球的空间感，很多次都空间就是溜到篮下，虽然说有时候不一定能接到传球。那能不能谈一下自己是怎么样去阅读对方防守，总是能找到空档这件事？
这点我跟小景学了很多，因为其实从不同球员身上可以学到不同的东西。那因为身为年轻球员，所以一直在学习。那小景有跟我说，就是看你的防守者，他如果一直盯着球的时候，这时候就是很好的后门时机，这样。所以，对，就像刚刚说的，从球队上不同的人来学习不同的东西。
这边再追问一个，就是因为秉胜，我们都知道秉胜是一个很强势的防守者。那今天他其实也是在你持球之后就一直对你加压，但你也没有示弱，就是两次一对一就是直接从后场就直接把他清爆这样。那能不能谈一下自己那两球，其实当下在想什么？因为看起来就是斗志有被他点燃的感觉，但是聊一下自己心情。
教练其实在练习当中就跟我跟先人说，其实我们速度比较快，所以假如说防守者比较贴，可以直接 drive to the basket。然后 中锋也会到另外一边，所以如果被守住的话，中锋也会有空档，所以其实这平常就练球的时候就开始在练。
好，我再补充比较轻松一题啦，就是这两天你情绪很高涨嘛，然后打得很投入，然后你有很多的肢体语言，或是有时候很懊恼打自己啊，或是很多人都说你的握拳给自己信心很可爱，或有时候很激动会跳起来，很多人都说，很多粉丝都说你这些举动很可爱，你自己怎么看？
其实我上场就是想办法带我的能量嘛，因为我是年轻球员。那至于那些动作，就是当下的反应，其实没有事先思考这些，对啊，就是刚好就是当下的反应是这样。